Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Tony Coniglia Memorial Gymnasium for the Spartan Classic, a yearly event run by St. Mary's here. This is the girls' version, and it's senior night as well. That's Olivia Nazaire presenting flowers to her family. Recent 1,000-point score. And she's the only senior. They'll announce the starting lineup for Essex Tech. One is Hannah Lilly, 12 is Madison Roy. 20 is Allison Reed. Number 24 is Virginia Viano. And 42, I'm guessing, is Callie D'Orlando, who was listed as 43 on the program. For St. Mary's, Nicole Dietria. Christina Nowicki. Gabby Torres. Pamela Gonzalez. And that one senior, Olivia Nazaire. St. Mary's 15-6, Essex 6-12. We'll have the national anthem and we'll have Spartan Classic basketball coming up. Hard to believe we're down to the last two games of the regular season. It's flown by. St. Mary's in the goal, Essex Tech in the blue. And we'll do the same thing for the boys in a couple of days. But right now it's the girls taking center stage. D'Orlando will jump against Gonzalez. Essex Tech will have the chance to get on the board first. Viano with the basketball. So here's, looks like a 1-3-1 zone. They try to go inside, they can't. Can't get the shot off. They finally get 3-point shot off, and it's good by Viano. They tripled up on D'Orlando underneath. Straight man-to-man by Essex. Dietrich doesn't take the shot, goes to the basket, dumps it down. Nice, nice pass to Nazir. Good job by the young freshman. Nazir gets St. Mary's on the board. St. Mary's goes full court pressure, 2-2-1. Essex handles it. And just as Vienna was about to take the shot, it got tripped out of her hands and went out of bounds. And if it seems like I sound different, it's because I have a horrible cold. They tried to go over the top to Gonzalez underneath. They went too far over the top and threw it out of bounds. For Essex Tech, this is their state tournament. Gonzalez slipped and fell, and the ball went out of bounds. She made the steal, she couldn't go to the basket. Stolen away by Dietria, missed the shot. They go over the top. They're doubling up inside, not letting them get anything in close. Tip and picked off by Dietria. Going to the basket. Lefty won't go. Torres saved it. Nazaire throws it up and gets fouled. I think it was Nowicki that saved it. And Nazaire following, picked it up, went to the basket and got hit. And she can give St. Mary's their first lead if she can make both. The best she could do now is tie it. And she does. She's got three and St. Mary's has got three. And they go back to that pressure. Essex Tech is a little bit different. They have co-coaches. Try to get it through. Torres stole it. Ahead to Dietria. Lays it in. Five in a row by St. Mary's. Tipped again, stolen away. Ahead to Gonzalez. Can't hit it. St. Mary's has missed a couple of chippies early. Almost taken away. Ball goes to the floor. They get it back. Shot too strong. Gonzalez comes away with it. Strong to the basket and lays it in. Goes tipped away. Nowicki comes up with it. She walks in and lays it in. Essex wants a timeout. St. Mary's has run nine in a row. St. Mary's looking for a sweep today. The boys basketball team defeated Classical out in the Comcast tournament in Woburn this afternoon. Second time they beat Classical. They beat them in the Boverini tournament. Not quite to the halfway mark of this first period, 9-3 St. Mary's. St. Mary's girls will be getting ready for the state tournament. Probably will not be getting a home game unless there's more than 16 teams in the tournament. St. Mary's keeps that 2-2-1 press on. Stolen away by Dietrich as she walks in and lays it in. 11 in a row by St. Mary's. Blocked by Gonzalez. She saved it, but right to Vienno. She was going out of bounds. They go up top. They're trying to go inside to get a shot off. They can't. Gonzalez winds up with it. She tried to slip it to Dietrich and threw it behind her. It went out of bounds. They threw it right to Torres. Nowicki kicks it out to Gonzalez for three. Off the rim, no good. The rebound by Lilly and Vienno. Pushing it up. Nice bounce pass inside. Couldn't hit the shot. Did everything right. Missed the layup. Gonzalez down the lane. Can't hit it. Final 3 minutes and counting of this first period. It's been all St. Mary's. Essex scored the first basket, and here's the second one. Lilly hit the shot. That ends the 11-0 run by St. Mary's. Torres off the rim. Dietria comes away with the rebound. Gives it back to Torres, down the lane. Shot is shot. Jeff Newhall's gonna make wholesale changes. Bounce pass picked off by Gonzalez. She tried to slip it in, she got it in, but the shot was missed. And Nowicki picks up the foul, reaching in and getting a piece of Vienno. Motella and Grossi and Nguyen and Ashley Sullivan are coming in the game. Nazir stays in. Nice pass in the lane to Vienno. She's got five. And they scored four in a row to get back in a little bit, 11-7. They try to go inside, get deflected away. Nguyen's pass hit the backboard. It's loose. Nazaire, tough shot. She got bumped as she was taking it. LeBlanc comes away with the rebound. They'll give it to Vienna to bring up. Essex can get a little closer. St. Mary's staying in that zone. They throw it right to Nazaire. Nguyen's shot is blocked. She gets it back. Gets it to Grossi. Can't hit it. Nguyen comes away with the rebound. Nazaire tries to step inside. Drops it in and gets fouled. Nguyen's shot got blocked, she got it back. Got it to Nazaire, she got double teamed, but she stepped between them and able to get the shot off. And that's the second foul on D'Orlando. She has to go out. So Nazaire trying to complete the three-point play. And she does. And now Ellie Reardon comes in and Nazaire goes out. So all of the starters on the bench for St. Mary's. Okay, Piano pass broken up. Sullivan strong to the basket, lays it in. Shot is shot. Grossi comes away with it. Sullivan gets tied up with Vienno, tied her up. Jump ball to be St. Mary's basketball. And I thought St. Mary's basketball, they're giving it to Essex. 3 seconds left, they're not going to get the shot off. Well, St. Mary's has a big first period. They get out. Essex scored the first basket. St. Mary's ran the next 11 points at the end of one. And St. Mary's 16, Essex Tech 7.
St. Mary's the basketball and a 9-point lead as we start the second 8 minutes.
Tipped away and picked off by LeBlanc. And LeBlanc took steps. She was going to throw it down court. Got blocked and she had to stop. And she took a couple of extra steps. But knocked out by Curley. Sullivan took steps. Just beat the 10-second clock. Shot is shot. Metella saved it right to Sullivan. Tough pass. She tried to throw it through three defenders. Had no chance to complete that pass. Vienno throws it in. She gets Essex Tech on the board first in the second period, like she did in the first period. Metella throws in a three. They try to go deep, and somehow they complete it. And somehow they get it back again after it got tipped. Living on the edge on those two passes. 3-point basket by LeBlanc. Their second of the day. Metella missed that one. Reardon battling for it. And it went out off Reardon. St. Mary's looking to make substitutions. Starting five will come back in the game. Two minutes into the second period. They go over the top. LeBlanc gives it back to Vienno. Stuck, she almost traveled. As she was falling down, she got rid of it. Along the baseline. We're gonna get a foul against St. Mary's. I said the starting five back in. Every starting four is back in. Evelino is in, replacing Nazir, who was in that starting five. Off the back rim with the first one. Essex has their starting five back on the floor. Off the rim, no good. Gonzalez with the rebound.
spins in the lane, gets hit, and she'll go to the line for two. Then she get inside the foul line, she spun around and got loose, and they hit her. She'll get two at the line. Off the rim, no good. Missed them both. She's usually a very good free throw shooter. Out off Gonzalez. Over the top to LeBlanc. They try to go inside. Gonzalez picked it off. Almost an impossible pass, and obviously it was because he didn't get it in. Dietrich off the rim, no good. Avellino with the rebound. The putback is good. Stuck in the backcourt. They just beat the 10-second clock. From dead in the corner, they throw in a three. Reed just turned around and said, I guess I'll throw it in. Their third trifecta. Torres throws it up and gets hit by LeBlanc. Torres looking for her first points from the free throw line. Misses the first. She nearly missed a couple. She makes one. They get stuck, they take it away. Torres. She took steps. Hanno in trouble. Somehow she got it to Roy. They get it up court. Almost threw it away. Lily saved it. Evelyn's gonna pick up the foul, and that's a big break for D'Orlando. She had no place to go. She was off balance taking the shot. It was going no place. And she got hit, and she'll get two at the line. Missed the first. One of those threes I have, I guess they gave two because I have the score as 15, board has 14. Banks that one in. Inside, Gonzalez steps around and lays it in. Nice pass from Nowicki. Free along the baseline. And she just stepped around and went from one side of the basket to the other and knocked it in. I guess there isn't a 10-second call because it took them a lot longer to get across. Nowicki. A little late with the pass, trying to get it in. It got blocked. tipped and knocked away and stolen away by Torres. Inside to Nazaire. Spins, throws it up, won't go. Lilly with the rebound. And Vienna will bring it up. Yeah, we had an offensive foul against Essex Tech. That's the third foul on D'Orlando. They kick it out to Nowicki for three. She knocks it down. Biggest lead for St. Mary's, 12, and now standing on the line was Roy when she caught the pass, and St. Mary's will get the basketball. Torres off the rim, no good. They're gonna get Nazaire for crashing the boards. Final 2 minutes of this first period. St. Mary's up by 12. Looking to get into the final of their own spot in Classic Tournament. Basket. Easy layup. There it is. Nowicki with an easy bucket. And all of a sudden, St. Mary's running away. They were up 9 at the end of 1. They've increased it to 16 with a 15-8 run here. ...31-15 St. Mary's. Looking for win number 16 on the season. And looking to get into the finals of their Spartan Classic. Three different divisions in this. 12 teams taking part all day here. This being Sunday and also on Monday. Divisions 1, 2, and 3. In division 3, along with Essex Tech. The putback is up and good by Curley. She's battling her own player for the rebound. Inside to Nazaire, steps up and drops it in. On senior night, we got a jump ball. It'll be St. Mary's basketball. A minute left. Inside to Nazaire for the chippy. She's got 10. And St. Mary's running away with this one. Steps called. She laid it in, but it won't count. St. Mary's could almost run the clock out. Easy bucket by Nazaire. She got six in each of the first two periods. And being in trouble, coaches for Essex Tech calls timeout. Thirteen seconds left. Shot clock is off, obviously. Lynn Tech, Essex Tech has the basketball. We just did the Essex Tech boys. They played Lynn Tech. That game was for Commonwealth Conference Small Championship, and Lynn Tech won it. Congratulations to Stevie Patrick. And we mentioned it today in the Comcast tournament. St. Mary's defeated intercity rival Lynn Classical out in Woburn. They had to travel to Woburn to play each other. So St. Mary's going to take a huge lead into the locker room. How well? Trying to go strong to the basket. The ball goes to the floor. Dietrich took it away, but we're going to get a jump ball with 2 seconds left. It'll be Essex Tech basketball. Do it. So St. Mary's went on that big 15-8 run after they had up 9 at the end of one. They built it up to a 20-point cushion. It's St. Mary's 37, Essex 17 at halftime. We're just about set to start the second half. 37-17 St. Mary's. I mentioned they're trying to make a sweep. St. Mary's boys beat Classical this afternoon in the Comcast tournament. I made a mistake and said that St. Mary's beat them for the second time. Classical beat them in the Wolverine tournament. So a little bit of revenge for the boys this afternoon, getting back at Classical for the loss in the Wolverine. St. Mary's will have the basketball and a 20-point lead as we start second half. St. Mary's will get to play Wilmington in the tournament final. Torres can't hit the shot. The ball goes to the floor. Dietria comes away with it. Not the biggest person on the floor, but she winds up getting the basketball quite often. That's a three for Gonzalez. Nowicki had 7. Dietria had 6. Isaiah had 12 to lead St. Mary's. Viano had 7. Viano was the only player on Essex to get more than one basket. Ball stolen away and they throw it too far. Torres has to save it. Tried to get it to Nazaire, it got stolen away. Viano in the lane. Somehow got it to Lily, and she throws it in. Nice job by Viano. She was on the floor and heads up finding Lily. They go inside to Nazaire. They kick it out to Gonzalez. Nazaire's going to get called for steps. They go over around and through about three people to try and get that shot off. Solomon's coming in. Torres is going out. St. Mary's now man to man. They were lucky to come get that pass through. Dietria battling, still battling. Weatherby took it away and she took steps. Nowicki kicks it out to Gonzalez. Sullivan takes the three. Off the rim, no good. Nazaire with the rebound. Back to Sullivan. Into Nazaire. Back in a way in. Gonzalez will take the shot and hit it for three. Her second trifecta in the period. Gives her 10. Around the rim and out. D'Orlando comes up with the rebound. Way cross court to Weatherby. Walks in, blocked by Gonzalez, taken away by Gonzalez. Dietria lets it fly off the rim, no good. Long rebound to Sullivan. Inside to Nazaire. Back out to Nowicki for three. Off the rim, no good. Lilly with the rebound will give it to Vienna to bring up. St. Mary's gets out of that full court pressure. They try to go inside, but they do, but they can't do anything with it. That was a wild shot. Had to try and beat the shot clock. D'Orlando just had to throw it up. Callahan comes in. Nicole Callahan. And Gonzalez goes out. Halfway through and counting this third period. The kick out to Dietria. Nowicki. Sullivan looked like it was gonna might pop out, stayed back in. It's a three-point shot. St. Mary's has three baskets, all three of them are threes. The runner is no good. Dietrich with another rebound. She seems to be in the right place all the time. Offensive foul against Dietrich. Torres is coming back. Metella is coming back as well. So it's Torres, Metella, Callahan, Sullivan, and Nazaire for the Lady Spartans. Knocked out by Torres. Stolen away by Torres. Nazaire, the kick out. Metella takes the long three, no good. Callahan tracks down the rebound. Underneath Nazaire. The follow-away, no good. Underneath, high off the glass, hung, floated all the way around the rim and wouldn't go in. Knocked away by Callahan. Yeah, Callahan was going to get called for the foul. Calhoun's going to pick up another foul. Avellino and Grossi getting set to come in the game. Nazir is going out. Callahan's going out. Stolen away, ball got bobbled. Grossi comes up with it, and she throws it away. She was looking for Torres, threw it too far ahead of her. Final 2 minutes of the third period. Torres is going to pick up a foul. Shot off the rim, no good. Sullivan comes away with the rebound. Torres from long range, knocks down a three. That's her first basket. She only had a free throw in the first half. The lead is ballooned to 30 for St. Mary's. Tipped away nicely by Torres. Grossi keeps it in play. Avellino tried to get control of it. It was bouncing around her hands. She couldn't get control. Finally lost it out of bounds. Essex only has one basket. Steps called. Inside to Avellino. Kisses it off the glass. Can't get the shot off. Tries to pass it inside. Went off the foot of Curley. Picked off Mantello. Wide open for the layup. Samirish has to throw it up. So another big period for St. Mary's. They hold Essex to two, and St. Mary's running away with this one. They have a huge lead at the end of three. 53-19, St. Mary's at the end of three. Essex has the basketball, and I can't say they got a mountain to climb because this one is over. Nguyen, this is virtually the JVs in there now for St. Mary's. 33 is Abigail Kornstein. This is her first varsity appearance. Van Nguyen, Reardon, Grossi, and Eliza Brown. Turnover gives it back to St. Mary's. Almost stolen away. Knocked out by Curley. 8 different scorers for St. Mary's. Stolen away by Roy. She gets stuck. Down the lane with the lefty. It's good by Lily. Lily and Vienno are the only ones with more than one basket. Vienno had 7 in the first half. She hasn't scored in the second half. Nice pass from Nguyen to Ridden. Ridden becomes the 9th scorer for St. Mary's. Knocked out by Grossi. Oh, Grossi. I gotta find out how to pronounce your name. And going to the basket was Weatherby. She bounced it off her foot. They tried to go inside, couldn't possibly make that pass. Roy, all by herself, lays it in. Her first basket. Brown gets hit, she'll go to the free throw line. Around the rim and out. Jenna Foley's coming in. That's her first varsity point. Eliza Brown coming up from the JVs. Too strong. And we got a foul inside. D'Orlando doing battle. Roy lets it fly, too strong. Weatherby comes away with it. Roy double dribbles. I called it before the official did. A little delay, but he called it. I was about to say she got away with it. Off the rim, no good. Foley will pick up the foul. Off the rim with the first one. Off the rim with the second one. Reardon with the rebound. Pass got deflected, but Brown came up with it. Foley gets shut off. Foley throws it in. Eleven scores for St. Mary's. Halfway through and counting. Ball bounced around, won't go. And we got a foul underneath. It'll go against Essex. Deanne down the lane. Lost it out of bounds. .334 left in the game. This one's been over for a long time. Big lead at halftime falling, holding Essex to 2 points in the third period. Now Nguyen takes it away. Can't hit the shot. And we're gonna get a foul against Nguyen. The only negative on the board are the fouls. Essex will be shooting free throws in the last 3 minutes and 8 seconds. That one didn't hit anything. Monsignor and Callahan are back. This is virtually the JV team. Nguyen, a wild shot. It gets loose. Jump ball, it'll be Essex Tech basketball. Wild shot by Nguyen. Vienna drove the lane, nice pass. Nice pass inside, can't hit the shot. Tipped away, Lilly comes up with it. Try to make the pass, it got picked off by Klon's team. Off the rim, no good. Vienna pushing it up. Tipped and stolen away by Brown. And we got a jump ball, it'll be St. Mary's basketball. Final 2 minutes and counting. So Essex Tech will play Amesbury in the consolation. St. Mary's will play Wilmington in the tournament final. Brown saved it, but right to Vienna. Almost stolen away. Nice bounce pass inside. Vienna to Lilly, she lays it in. Nice play, 1 minute and counting. Underneath to Callahan, lost it, gets it back. Kicks it out to Nguyen, she takes the three. Off the rim, no good. Hunstein missed the shot. Up and good by Curley. Shot clock is off. St. Mary's can just hold the basketball. They go inside to Callahan, she missed the shot. She had the layup. Nice pass from Nguyen. Wild shot. Off the rim, no good. Tip. Foley lost it, gets it back. That's going to do it. So an easy win for St. Mary's. They'll move into the final yet again. They've won this tournament quite a few times. They'll move into the final of their Spartan Classic, and they'll take on Wilmington. Essex Tech led once. They got a three-point basket by Vienna starting the ball game. St. Mary's ran 11 in a row and just put the pedal to the metal after that and just kept adding to it. And it wound up a 31-point win, 58-27. For Essex, Lily had 8, Vienna had 7. On the other side, Reardon had 2, Avellino had 4, Torres had 4, Brown had 1, Foley had 2, Dietria had 6, Sullivan had 5, Nowicki had 7, Metella had 5, Gonzalez had 10, and Nazir, the 2,000-point scorers, Gonzalez with 10, the other 1,000-point scorer, Nazir, was the leading scorer in the ball game with 12, and they sat most of the second half. So St. Mary's will go to 16-6. Essex will drop to 7-12. Essex will play Amesbury in the 2018 Spartan Classic consolation game. St. Mary's will try to win yet another classic. They'll be taking on Wilmington in the final of the Spartan Classic. So we hope you enjoyed it. 58-27 St. Mary's, they go to 15-6. And they'll move on to the Spartan Classic final. We hope you enjoyed it. I'm Don Hoppe saying we'll see you next time.